Hey guys, how are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the CSE 2019 and also CSE 2020, and for this purpose we have multiple series on our channel that basically prepare you people for your respective exam, either it is CSE mains 2019 or CSE 2020. So a request was made by students that sir, please upload the reference sources for the questions that you daily post for the purpose of answer writing. So as I have told you that it is difficult to upload or we can say discuss all the questions on YouTube, but certainly we have decided that we will be discussing one question at least daily, and which will help you in getting an idea about how to write the answer. So let's start. So today's question is about the discuss the provisions of Muslim Women Protection of Rights on Marriage Bill 2019. Why it has been opposed by certain sections of opinion. So we have to look at the answer of it. So let me tell you friends that this is not a model answer. You have to take this only as a reference source, because no answer can be a model answer in UPSC, because had that been the case, then toppers would have scored 100% marks, but it is not the case. So only we can say every answer has its own we can say positives and negatives. So for that purpose we only say that it is a reference source. So let's see the discussion. So let me tell you friends that you don't have to write an exact word to word manner in which we are writing. Here our purpose is also to give you an idea about that what this bill is all about. So this is basically a long pending demand. So triple talaq is basically a practice in Islam in which that is talaq is given to the woman by simply pronouncing talaq three times in a single sitting. So there has been a long pending demand that it must be done away with, because it is no longer feasible and it is not in consonance with women rights and also with in consonance with we can say modern outlook. So it was a long pending demand, and demand was made by different sections of society, and also there is a Bharatiya Muslim Mahila Andolan which in 2010 conducted a survey in which they introspected 4710 Muslim women in 10 states, out of which 80% women responded that triple talaq must be banned. So what is basically the issue about? So in this bill, what this bill is all about? So this bill makes your triple talaq void and illegal. So it seeks to make the practice of instant triple talaq a punishable offense with imprisonment up to 3 years. So what's the issue all about? So let's see, let's have a brief history. So here the case date back to 2016, because in 2016 Supreme Court had sought the opinion from Attorney General Mukul Rohtagi to understand that what is the central government stance over the constitutional validity of triple talaq, nikah halala and polygamy. So to assess whether the Muslim women are facing gender discrimination or not in cases of divorce. So in this at that time the central government came with the view that we are opposed to this practice, and it also center also said that the issue demands a relook, keeping in mind that two important aspects, that is gender equality and secularism. However, Supreme Court later announced that a 5-judge constitutional bench should be there to properly assess the issue and deliberate on the challenges and also on the constitutional validity and other host of issues that would be addressed by this the case. For example, women rights and gender equality, women empowerment. So for that purpose, a special constitutional bench was constituted and it deliberated upon this practice of triple talaq, nikah halala and polygamy. So the issue particularly gained political momentum in March 2017 when this All India Muslim Personal Law Board told that Supreme Court cannot interfere in the process of this triple talaq because triple talaq is basically an issue of personal law in which the Supreme Court has no right to interfere. So, but the Supreme Court on August 22, 2017 declared this decade-old settle this issue, and it declared that instant triple talaq will be null and void. That is, it will be no longer enforceable. If in case it is the triple talaq is given to women by using this practice, then that talaq will not be valid because it is violative of Article 14 and Article 21 of the Constitution. So Article 14 is about equality before law and equal protection of law. So, and Article 21 is about right to life. So, thus the Supreme Court settled the issue, but then the government came with a bill. So in September it introduced a bill that is Muslim Woman Protection of Rights on Marriage Bill, but this bill lapsed due to the dissolution of 16th Lok Sabha. But the new government, which is in power now, and that is NDA 2 government, brought the same bill again, and it has been now introduced in Lok Sabha. So the key provisions of the bill are, that is, declaration of talaq by written or electronic form will be void. That is, it will not be enforceable in law and illegal. To this extent, it is good because this judgment was also the same, because the Supreme Court said that it will be null and void. So also it provided the definition about this bill, and it said that it defined the talaq as talaq-e-biddat or any other form of talaq pronounced by a Muslim man resulting in instant and irrevocable divorce. So it is basically a practice in Muslim personal laws where pronouncement of talaq thrice in one sitting by a Muslim man results in the irrevocable divorce. So this talaq-e-bidat was declared illegal, void and unconstitutional. However, in this bill, the government went step further and it brought it under the category of cognizable offense, which could attract imprisonment of 3 years with a fine. So what is a cognizable offense? So cognizable offense is that offense in which a police officer may arrest an accused person without the warrant. So the offense will be cognizable only if the information relating to offense is given by the woman who is affected by such a talaq, or by the married woman against whom the talaq has been declared, or if any person related to her by blood or marriage informs about such an incident, then the offense will become cognizable. So also it provides that magistrate can grant the bail to the accused who has pronounced the talaq, but the bail can only be granted after hearing the woman against whom the talaq has been pronounced. And also if magistrate is satisfied that there are reasonable grounds for granting the bail, then the bail will be granted. However, there is a provision that the offense can also be compounded. Compounded means that is if both the parties, that is husband and wife, agree to settle the dispute by stopping the legal proceedings. So this is a kind of, we can say, mutual agreement between the different parties to settle the dispute outside of the court. So magistrate can compound the offense provided the woman makes such request, and also the conditions will be decided in this case by the magistrate. And also there is a provision about allowance to the woman. So a woman to whom the talaq has been pronounced is entitled to your subsistence allowance and her from her husband for herself and for her dependent children. So the amount of allowance will also be determined by the magistrate. So also the custody of children is given to women. So she is entitled to seek the custody of her minor child, children, if she wanted. Then also the manner of custody will also be determined by the magistrate. Now let's come to the actual issue, that what is the current issue. So now the feminists are opposing the bill in this regard. So it may sound ironical and it may sound surprising that why those very feminists who were demanding its the banning of the practice, why they are opposing the bill. So here a group of 40 women right activists, they submitted their objections a few months back about the bill, and these are in fact they are valid. We can say the issues that are raised by them, they are valid to certain extent. So let us look at the other side also. So certainly it is necessary to ban such practice, but we have to look at the other side also. The first thing is this bill disregards the fact that its objective has already been achieved by Supreme Court judgment, because Supreme Court has already declared that triple talaq is a practice which will no longer be considered legal, and it will have no effect on the marriage relationship. So when the Supreme Court has already declared that, then why the bill should be brought in to declare when the objective has been already fulfilled. So the second objection is that Supreme Court held that this is unconstitutional and arbitrary. So obviously that the act now, the pronouncing of a triple talaq, thus will have no legal consequences. So when a particular action doesn't have any legal consequences, then why it should be made a criminal and cognizable and non-bailable offense? Because it shows that it is arbitrary, and also it is violative of Article 14. And other thing is that there is no rationale to the women are saying that there is no rationale to criminalize the practice and imprison Muslim men, because the effect of the Supreme Court ruling is that marriage will remain legally valid, and the person will continue to be lawfully wedded. And in that case, why to criminalize the husband? So criminalizing husband, what will it do? It will further create, further widen the gulf between the couple that already has dispute with each other. So this will this may cause unwanted damage to the relationship, so that reconciliation will not take place. So other thing is that penal action is to discourage instant triple talaq, but they say that it is a myopic vision, because it leaves many other issues of economic and social security of women unaddressed. So what does it mean? So it means that these women are saying that if after making it cognizable offense, when the man or the husband will be arrested, then who will provide the economic allowance to the woman, or where she will stay? Because ultimately if her husband has been imprisoned, and also there is a provision in the bill to provide allowance, and when the husband is behind the bars, how can he arrange for the money to pay for the social economic needs of the concerned woman? And also it is the women are saying that the government should strengthen the negotiating capacities of women by providing them economic as well as social legal support, but not by criminalizing the triple talaq. Other thing is that only criminalizing this act of desertion of a Muslim wife by her husband. So the bill has been trying to make this as a criminal offense. So the objection has been raised that when in other religions this issue of divorce is only a civil issue, then why particularly Muslim men are targeted by making this offense a criminal offense? So it is they are saying that it is discriminatory under the Constitution, and it also violates Article 14 of the Constitution, that is equality before law and equal protection of law. So seventh point that has been raised by them is that if the government thinks that the violence is there in the marriage, in addition to the pronouncement of triple talaq, then women have already other provisions which they can use to address their grievances. For example, if there is a case of domestic violence also in addition to triple talaq, then there is a proper Domestic Violence Act 2005, and then also there is Section 498 of the IPC. So the women can invoke these provisions. Why to separately make a law for this? And also other thing is that no economic and social legal support is provided. As I have told you that how will the woman and her children and her other dependents will kind of sustain themselves when the erring men are put behind bars. So this is the issue. Other thing is that ninth point that has been raised by them is that anybody who is related to women by blood or by marriage can be a complainant. So here the activists are saying that this will be misused, especially in the cases of interreligious marriages. If in case, for example, the girl is Hindu or other from other religion, then her relatives can without seeking her consent can proceed to the court and can thus put the husband behind the bars. So this problem will aggravate and there will be kind of we can say bogus or we can say fake kind of manufacturing of this crime. So other thing is that jail term is up to 3 years, is arbitrary and excessive. So they are saying that this is 3 years is a quite long term, because other serious offenses, for example death by rash or negligent act, and also rioting and injuring or defiling a place of worship with intent to insult the religion, all these are the punishable offenses with jail term up to 2 years. So these are serious crimes, then why such arbitrary and excessive punishment is given? So this is the main issue that has been raised by the activists. So conclusion should be basically conclusion is that this bill can increase the destitution among Muslim women, and when a husband is jailed, then certainly there will be no chance for we can say compromise, because husband will also we can say become it will be then difficult to kind of we can say melt the attitude of husband or for that matter wife. And also when husband is jailed, then there is the issue of maintenance allowance, how the lady should get it. And also it will not save her marriage, worse, it will not save her marriage. If in case, for example, woman does not want to be separated from her husband, and she wanted to remain her house, but in case, for example, her parents moved to the court saying that the triple talaq has been pronounced by her husband, then this will can further increase the problem, because incarcerating the husband will not ensure that she will stay in her in his house, and also she gets her the economic rights to which she is entitled. So how other thing is that how will a poor illiterate woman can continue with the case, because it would be difficult for her to follow up a rigorous and daunting criminal prosecution against her husband and secure a conviction. Further, there is issue of shelter and sustenance, and then what will be the conviction? More importantly, what will be the conviction give the aggrieved woman? It doesn't give woman anything substantial. So convicting the husband for 3, 7 or even 10 years cannot ensure that she has the food on the table to feed her children, money to clothe them or educate them, which are the primary concerns of any woman. And also other thing that I have told you that this is a kind of repetition of the things. So if the ultimate goal of the woman is to save their marriage, then this bill is not in that spirit. So that's other thing is that the campaigners are saying that when triple talaq has already been banned, then why such a haste has been why the government is proceeding with such a haste. So this is all about today's this question about the Muslim provisions of Muslim Women Protection of Rights Act, bill. So the basic purpose of this was to make you familiar with various aspects. So here you have to just what to do. For the purpose of your convenience, I have provided you the entire history, but you have to just begin by its important provisions, so you can provide the provisions in single line. So here you can give us brief introduction, and then you can provide the provisions, you can tell the provisions in single line, and then you can move on to the issues. So this is all about, friends, today's video, and if in case you are interested to join our test series, you can join us. And if you have any queries, you can mail us at this email ID, or you can also contact us. And the link for the subscription to our test series will be given in the description box. And also if you want to get the reference material of all the questions, then you can join our test series. So this is all about today's video. Thank you, have a very nice day.